We adore performance. Less Spartan, more powerful, more attractive. Today's estate car has nothing to envy to other passenger cars. On the other hand, it retains what has always made the segment special, a long silhouette, and above all a large load volume. This segment was still in its infancy, and no one knew if there was really a customer base for this type of car. But the Lion brand knew it was onto something good, so much so that it offered Peugeot 308 station wagon, a family estate car. The wheelbase of the new Peugeot 308 SW has been extended by 55 mm compared to the saloon. This change provides more space for the rear passengers, and also gives the car a more solid silhouette, which appears to stand firmly grounded on its four wheels. The new Peugeot 308 has a 10-inch 3D digital instrument cluster, and an innovative 10-inch high-definition central touchscreen with the new Peugeot iConnect Advanced. Fully configurable eye toggles replace the traditional physical controls. The small steering wheel, another integral part of the Peugeot iCockpit, allows the driver to become truly one with the car. Power certainly isn't something you miss in this most potent version of the 308. The sub 8-second 0-62 mph time feels entirely plausible, with the petrol motor backed up by a big swell of torque from the electric motor. Switch to fully electric mode and the 109 bhp from the e-motor means that there's still enough poke to at least keep up with the flow of traffic. It's possible to force the car into electric drive via the drive mode switch. Officially, it'll be able to drive like this for 37 miles before the petrol engine fires into life again. Combined with emissions of 25 grams kilometer, the 308 FEV sits in the 11% benefit in kind tax band. The Peugeot battery top-ups get a 3.6 kilowatts charger as standard, which means a home recharge takes 3.5 to 4 hours, but the 308's optional 7.4 kilowatts charger drops this to just under 2. There's quite a range of petrol and diesel engines to choose from, and most have impressive economy and emissions. The 1.2-liter PureTech petrol engines may sound too small for a car as big as this, but they're certainly strong enough. It's much the same story with the 1.5-liter diesel engine, which is the other option across most of the range. They offer similar performance to the petrol engines, and their better fuel economy is some compensation for their higher price. There are a couple of bigger engines available, a 1.6-liter petrol and a 2.0-liter diesel, but they're only available with the range-topping GT trim, which makes them very expensive options. Whichever engine you choose, you'll have a car with a maximum 5-star Euro NCAP safety rating. And even the most basic active model comes well-equipped, with dual-zone climate control, a 10-inch touchscreen, sat-nav and alloy wheels. Probably the main reason for buying an estate rather than a standard hatchback is the boot, and the good news is that the Peugeot 308 SW has one of the best in the business. With the rear seats upright, it can accommodate 660 liters of stuff, and that figure rises to 1,775 liters when you drop the rear seats. Given how much it can carry, it's no surprise that the 308 SW follows the hatchback in having quite a soft suspension setup. Mostly, that makes for a relaxing and easy drive, with only the worst lumps and bumps felt in the cabin. Peugeot 308 SW, price start from €29,800, and Peugeot 308 SW Hybrid price start from €40,700.